What's up, guys? It's your boy Keaton, freaking Bender, and I'm back in this with Easy Mo. We on the success train, bro. There ain't no stopping this. We're just flying through, just swah. Now, guys, you have suggested to me that I should hit up 27 bodies from Easy Mo. Like I said, we're gonna pop on the closed captions, and we are gonna deep dive. Okay, we're gonna go swimming in the pool of Easy Mo's tracks and start to discover why you guys love him so much. Guys, if you're brand new to this channel, make sure you hit the subscribe, thumbs up, and notification bell. And without further ado, let's get straight into it. And will it get the clap? Woo! Easy Mo, 27 bodies.
Wala namang magtataka kung gusto niya na siya ay sumisit sa gilid ng himig ng aking pag-ibig chungke ang
Yassi, bro, in like 2 seconds we got friggin' bars. That, what was that? No one's gonna doubt it if she wants to be the
Tataka kung gusto niya na siya ay sumisit sa gilid.
Want to swim along the melody shorelines of my love. Damn! My man going Shakespeare, bro, on them. That is amazing. Okay. Sorry, guys, there is going to be pausing. We are breaking down the track. Okay, we are reacting, but we are also breaking down the track.
Nahimig ng aking pag-ibig chungke ang piniling ihitid maliban sa kisig ng tinig ng parang sa tingnan ng inyong narap. Wala sa inyong mananarap. Kung tumalos ang dalos sa
puno. I didn't even hear the... I didn't even read the lyrics, bro. That drop. Dude, I love when he actually raps in vernac. Like, your guy's like native tongue, the way that he does it is so like deep and emotive. It's so sick, bro. I feel like that's one thing as well, is that when you speak in vernacular like that, it carries through the pain, the strength, the misery, the etc. You know what I'm saying? Much more than the language you have to learn, if that makes sense.
Pag-ibig chungke ang piniling ihitid maliban sa kisig ng tinig ng parang sa tenga ninyo ay nararo. Wala sa inyong mananalo pag ako ang tumalos.
Literally saying that she, instead of like going with the love of the shores, oh my god. Okay, hold on. I lost my train of thought. It's left. I'm ADHD. Deal with it. Hold on.
Parang sa tenga ninyo ay nararo. Wala sa inyong mananalo pag ako ang tumalo sundalo sa punot ng baril ko manggago ng talo.
Hey, you see, just reiterating the same thing that he was saying on that other track, bro. If he needs to pull up, he's gonna pull up. There's nothing you can do to stop the man from pulling up, bro. He's like, you need to be a soldier with it, okay? Exactly the same as choose your game players, okay, willingly. I think that Easy Mo just keeps reiterating the fact that he's not to be fucked with on a gangster level and on a rap level, like street level and rap level. Don't play with the boy. Don't play with him.
Ingat ang lahat sa pagpili ng inyong manlalaro. Kasi I didn't come to play with you chump bitches who think this a fun business. A one click is that'll come and buck when it's none witness. To live off a crunk grimness. You stuck sitting in your sleep like I wanna stuck riches. But
yes, it's in the flow. The flow. Sorry, I know I stopped right there, but I can't. Wait, hold on.
Come to play with you chump bitches who think this a fun business. A one click is that'll
think of the fun business. A one click is. You see what I'm like this once again coming back to his cadence, the way that he's hitting the last like letter of the word run clicks run sitis. He's always like over pronunciates the S, and it like just works so well flowing into like each and next like line, like each bar is just flowing nicely because of that.
Come and buck when it's none witness to live off a crunk grimness. You stuck sitting in your sleep like I want to stuck riches, but that ain't the case. Cause I done got it, your place. I'm leaving holes in your humble bowler pat his face in the
Ah! The beat is disgusting. Who produced this beat? He said, I'm leaving holes in you like pat in his face. There was some rapper in the 90s that got shot, so maybe that's the reference, because he's literally saying that. Like, they're gonna come through when no one's around, bro. They're gonna take you out, like, no witnesses, no nothing. So I'm guessing that the Pat bar is in reference to that. because there was a rapper, I think it was like Pat the Mat or Pat something, that got shot in like the 90s. That's where I'm coming from. That's the only Pat I know that got shot.
I'm a witness to live off a crunk grimness. You stuck sitting in your sleep like I wanna stuck riches, but that ain't the case, cause I done got it. Your place, I'm leaving holes in your humble Ebola pat. This face on a suma line, no one know who you be, now I knock, no it's suddenly what's...
Rested in peace when I was born. Oh, so he's saying, oh, 1998. Yes, yes, it is that fucking rapper, bro. So he was born the same time and year when that rapper died because he got shot in the face. Come on, bro. Come on, bro. Who else caught that? Tell me. Tell me I'm here, bro.
The bullet pattern. Face on the summer lines, no one know who you be, nang a knock, no it's suddenly, but some na put wallow ang tatak. Yeah, di na to pata sa makatarong pag ako.
Oh!
But some na put wallow ang tatak. Yeah, di na to pata sa makatarong pag ako sumali. Why, tayong katwiran na kayang gumamit ng tatlong lingwahe. Die up in the coffin, it's where you were destined to be. I'ma just...
Wait, three languages, what? What three languages does he speak? Obviously Filipino, English. What's the other language that he speaks? I'm curious. Bro, this guy is multi-talented. He is multi-talented.
I think that we're in a high and go mommy than that lingwahe. Die up in the coffin is where you were destined to be. I'ma just rest in the lead and flex on your bitch, cause I can kill you for free.
You were saying that he's gonna rest in the lead because he's already ahead of everyone else, bro, and flex on her. He said like when you stay asleep and he's stunting, so like he's already flexing and everything. You are staying asleep, bro. You are not awake like the man is awake. Whoa.
Bitch, cause I can kill you for free. Old school up in this motherfucking party, like I'm switching the blades and tipping the babes and making sure my flow is boom bap, not that new trap.
And boom bap is that 90s rap, bro, when they used to bust out bars, bro. They used to hit rhymes. They used to smash it, bro. Boom bap used to be all about like your lyrical skill and your ability, how great you can come at your opponent, what level, and then you had to prove yourself on the microphone. It's not like nowadays, like where you're saying, like, you see the hi-hats and stuff, because trap nowadays is like all similar, and it's all like auto-tune, whereas boom bap was like hard beat, prove who you are, and prove that you can do it.
Hi-hats go like that repetitive shit.
Hey!
You just jealous cause you wanna kiss my neck and my dick, cause heaven is rich.
Sorry. Do you hear the beat flipping backwards there? Do you hear, bro? And then he even like threw in his beatboxing skills. Damn. Woo. Shit.
Repetitive shit. You begging your bitch. You just
there. You begging the bitch. You said it in the bit. This is amazing, bro. I won't even lie. This track I was not ready for.
Jealous cause you wanna kiss my neck and my dick, cause heaven is rich, I'll rob it with my devilish clip. And 22 double O is what I'm a rep on the shit.
22 double O is what I rep on the shit. That's obviously his hood or his city or whatever. I'm guessing like from the other one that I reacted to, the Yo, he said Oka lava la 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 la, whatever. What's it called, guys? What's his city called?
If shit, you begging your bitch. You just jealous cause you wanna kiss my neck and my dick, cause heaven is rich, I'll rob it with my devilish click.
Heaven, okay, devilish click, cause he's running with a pack of people that do hellish things like murder, etc. Like I said, 2200 is definitely his city or his area code. That's why he's repping it. Come on.
22 double lows, but I'm a rep on the shit.
Oh my god, we have a flow switch even. Oh, easy mail.
But that's like the extent of all that. I ain't trying to take it further. I ain't trying to be like all doing all that petty beef and shit, like all of you rappers out there.
Bro, my man has straps, like he's armed and ready to go to war, bro. I don't think you want to mess with Easy Mill, bro. Because this guy's not just... It just seems like he's not just about rapping. He's also about that life, okay? And you know when someone's really about that life? Bro, they will do things. They will do things.
I'm gonna discuss a topic that I feel is close to my heart because it's back home. And it's happening here too, dog, like... They just have no fucking control.
And the freaking do, do as like a break after like that hectic, like crazy level of like drums and intensity. Like it just allows you to stop and breathe and just, you know, just to take in the track because he's put so much on your shoulders here.
And I'm tired of it. Yo. Asulat pula ang aking lahi na puno na tula. Tukol sa hay nang bawal mauta. At hindi lang dahil kayaman ang buka. Mga labi namin sa pag-asa lang uulan ng panalangin sa masa magtutura.
Oh my God, goose flesh, bro. Goose flesh. Oh, oh, oh my God, bro. This is amazing. Dude, this is so deep. Yes, this is so good. This is so good. This is so good.
Asulat pula ang aking lahi na puno na tula. Tukol sa hay nang bawal mauta. At hindi lang dahil kayaman ang buka. Mga labi namin.
We can't wealthily open. They are poverty stricken. You see what I'm saying? Wealthily open. People don't open themselves to give wealth out to these people that are in poverty. Our lips to a certain hope that we rain with prayers. You know, raining down hope. You want to bring hope into the entire situation because hope literally is what drives us in order to believe that something can happen, in order to believe that we can achieve something. You need hope. You need hope. And this guy gives hope to everyone in the Philippines.
Sa pag-asa lang uulan ng panalangin sa masa magtutura ng salita ay naulit na ulit hanggang lahat ng tao mauuta. Habang buhay na lang ba tingin sa akin puta kang asang hospitalisirugot.
Jeez, like it. You see what he's saying? He's gonna keep repeating it so the message is clear. The message keeps coming through to you guys of the struggles that they're going through.
Habang buhay na lang ba tingin sa akin puta kang asang hospitalisirugot yung kapatid mo may pera ka pa ba?
Bro, and this is like his inner thoughts and stuff, or like everything that he asked himself or that he's asking about his country, about his people. It's so deep, dude. It's so deep. This track has taken me off guard. Of gods. Should it just be forever? Forever the situation in terms of what they're doing. Eyes on me, you little fuck. I'm guessing that's abuse that he must have had to deal with. Which hospital did they admit your sibling? Can that be a result from the abuse? You guys let me know. Am I reaching? Am I finding my way here? Do you have any money left? I feel that one, bro. That happens a lot, bro. There's been many situations, dude, where I'm on the lease. Granted, I have a completely different situation, bro. I have a roof over my head, I have food, etc. But there are times where there is no money, nothing, bro. Nothing, nothing. Everything is just covering everything that you just left with a small amount. Still haven't learned your lesson. This is also feeling like he may have gone through abuse. What's your problem, Ezekiel? You guys hit me up that his name is Ezekiel and I didn't know that. So thank you. I appreciate that. Yeah, man. Shit. Okay. We continue on. Sorry, guys. I know I've been pausing in that. I just feel like with tracks like this that there's a lot to interpret and you don't want to lose any of those essences.
Pero ang totoo ay lunod na lunod na ako sa hiya. Lahat na aking mga kasalanan ay laging magiging lakas ko sa laban. Dahil lang simple mamalagi ay laging naghahanam ng kanyang pwedeng katahanan. Pamamara sa laban. Meron sila na may katanat tungkol sa akin. Pero wala akong takot kung ako ipain.
Bro, there's a lot to break down here, guys. Let's just go line by line here, okay? So he says, all of my strengths will be I mean, all my sins will be my strength in battle. So all of the things he has gone through has given him that experience that he is strong enough to go through the battles that he is facing. Abidance will always look for its next escape mate. Yeah, so like a scapegoat, always looking for a reason. Abidance, so always in accordance to laws, regulations, etc. But looking for escape mate, a way out of that. You know, that you follow your own path. You have your own path of freedom. Oh, I remain fearless even though they use me as bait. And you see, when he was talking about the blue and the red, and now the blue and the red can be referenced to cops, but here he's switching between red, which is the intensity, the poverty, the darkness, and now he's moving to the blue. Okay. And you see, he's even changed it different now. Now his voice is higher pitched. It's even like it's gone darker in the sense of sadness. So it's rage and then sadness. Yo, okay, these are deep, bro. These are deep. They tampered with the media base hold like a conscious demon. A conscious demon is aware of itself. It's aware of the destruction it is causing and its evilness. So that's what he's basically interpreting as. Next line. Literally, so he's now alluding to the fact that the media is this demon that is just feeding all these narratives to the people, and instead of helping them, it is literally destroying them. And this comes back to like propaganda, brainwashing, etc., that the government does, that all these institutions do to bring down the people, because they are greedy. They want to have the most amount of money to themselves, bro. They want to control the narrative and how the people move. Yo, connected with synapses. Your synapses is what sends the signal. So he's basically building this entire image of this monster, this media monster, just disgusting, feeding all of these messages out. Okay. You end up distracted by all the factors within the prism, simulating spiral to fix up the soul, eliminating cycle, the tricks of the image, this remaining. Oh my god, bro. Every time I feel like I know what's gonna happen, it's just a flow switch, it's just a beat change, it's just wordplay, it's cadence, it's wow. Nexus and nexus, so you never know whatever happens. If you trace them, you end up distracted by all the factors within the. If you trace it, you'll end up distracted because there's just so many branches of this evil, bro, that you cannot keep focused on the mission that you need to go at, because everything else will distract you from the main picture. Prison. Simulating spiral to fix up the soul eliminating cycle, the trick setter. Fuck, bro, listen to that wordplay. Even prism simulating spiral to fix up the soul eliminating cycle. Okay, so exactly the prism. So we've been held by all of these powers that be, soul eliminating cycle, because it's just going like this and just destroying the people, destroying their souls, that they're left with essentially nothing, bro. They don't want to be anything but these mindless zombies that have to work every day to feed money back into the system. Image that's remaining idle because they know they're taking away all your problems by taxing it. Yeah, my man is attacking the government. He's attacking this system that is destroying the Philippines, that is leaving them poverty stricken in such dark times. Because I've even watched like the documentaries on the Philippines, the jails and the prisons, bro, and it's fucked up. It's inhumane. It's inhumane. It's inhumane. Lessened the lesson to not pay enough for the aeronautical enhancement. Shit, bro. My man can just manipulate words like crazy. Stuff in the black, the minute get the bad and the rough for the one that innovated passion for us, so we trust them and but burn away all the opposites, because when we at the war with no other pissing. Bro, he is literally so deep into this narrative. It's crazy. It's crazy. So you see, even for the war, they innovate a passage for us so we trust them. Yes, because they are giving you a concise, clear path. Clear. That they can hide what is actually happening. That once you're on that path, you discover the real shit that is happening. And none of it is in the people's favor. You see, burn away the opposition. So you had to go to war in order to make enough money in order to support your family that don't even have a pot to piss in. Literally, that is a reference to not even having a working toilet because of so much poverty and poorness. Ooh, poofing like a genie, because the genie disappears back into the lamp. That's also giving a false narrative that you want all these wishes, but that's not true that you can achieve those things. Okay, and then at the sight of money, we fall victim to some Cubans and models. Cuban cigars, bro. So essentially, he's saying that the minute you have some money, you fall victim to the good life, to wanting like a baddie, a girl, a this, models. And then the Cubans, obviously, the rich and the elite have Cuban cigars because it is literally a sign of wealth, but it is also a sign that you have made it to a certain wealth category because Cuban cigars are so expensive. Chopper extended banana magazine. It's just that extended magazine like this that they just let rip off, bro. That just. Oh, rubbing on the trigger, poofing like a genie, disappearing, murder. Alright. Got a personifications on the TV until they end up inside obituaries. Okay. Oh, and that switch, bro, from English into his vernacular. So smooth, so clean. What he was just saying here is gutter personifications, personification of people that are in the gutter, that are poor, that are poverty stricken, until they end up in obituaries, essentially until they die of their circumstances. Let's go from the English to his vernacular. Ooh! Yo, repeated content. He's essentially saying how many times he's got to say the message like he said earlier. Even reaching the YouTube trending section that it's not worth joking about. Yeah, you see, bro. So he's saying even though he's hitting the highest highs, it's not a joke what they're going through. Therefore, you need to listen to his message in order to understand these people need help. Yo, the evil ones become the particular heroes. That's facts, bro. That's facts, bro. Easy ball, tell them. Yeah, guys, that was Easy Mole 27 bodies. What he was saying at the end there, I forgot to press pause. Basically, that the fakest models, the ones that have been done up, etc., are the favorites of these corrupt individuals because they become the heroes because the narrative is pushed through media, etc. Meanwhile, they are the greedy ones that are destroying the planet and everything going forward. Guys, does it get the clap? Bro, come on, dude. Come on, bro. That was amazing. That was a masterclass in fucking writing, in flow, in cadence, in wordplay, in beat selection, multiple beats, multiple flow switches, wordplay, fucking everything, bro. Everything. Easy Mole, you get a 10, bro. You get a 10! You get a 10! Guys, it's been Kingdom Motherfucker Bender, your boy. Make sure to hit subscribe, thumbs up, notification bell. Which one should I do next? This one was insane. I don't even know where we're going to go through here. Go through, go below, get it, go. I don't have words. I'll catch you on the next one. Let's go.